Good evening. Thank you for hosting me and for arranging this webinar. As you have said, Sarah, my name is Farid Tamallah. I'm originally from a village located between Ramallah and Nablus. Along the week, I am in Ramallah, but at the weekends, usually I used to go to the village, to my farm, to do farming, but now since the beginning of this war, I have no access to the land, and it's very difficult for us Palestinians to move from one place to the other. The Israeli soldiers and checkpoints and roadblocks are making it very difficult for Palestinians to move from Ramallah, for example, to the village or vice versa. The main roads are dedicated only for the settlers, while Palestinians cannot move on the main roads. So if I want to go to my village, I should go through tiny roads among the Palestinian communities. And in most of the cases, you can find a gate or a closure or a roadblock here and there. Just to let you know that every Palestinian community, whether a city, a refugee camp, or a village, the Israelis have set a gate on the entrance of every Palestinian community. And this is not new. This is since 2002, 20 years. So every time, for security reasons, the Israeli army can close and simply block the roads, and you are not allowed to get into the village. And that happens with me many times while I'm trying to reach my land, my property, my farm. But after the October 7th, it's intensified more. It's more difficult for me. So the main influence of the war on me is that I cannot access my land. And you know that October, usually in Palestine, October and November is the season for olive harvest. Palestinians, and the olive harvest is the main season for Palestinians to make a living. And I own also a big farm of olive trees. So during the war, I used to leave from Ramallah to the village, but I cannot go and come every day. So I have to leave my kids and my wife in Ramallah because they have schools. And I'm in the village for like a week or 10 days. I cannot see them. They cannot come to see me. And then I do the opposite. I go back to Ramallah for another 10 days to be with my family. And then because the way from Ramallah to my village is very difficult. And this is my case is not a unique case. This is what is happening everywhere in the West Bank. But as Sarah said, that we feel shy to talk about our atrocities while the war in Gaza is more fierce and the destruction and genocide taking place there. So sometimes I feel really impressed to talk about these small problems in comparison to what's happening in Gaza. But in general, the main problem we face here in the West Bank are the settlers and the settlements, which is making our life miserable, and they are attacking Palestinians, and maybe we will talk about it more later.